coming back, coming to a competition we just entered recently in 2019 in Srinagar, in Kashmir, is a project which is reuse of these 120-year-old silk factories done by the Britishers into converting it into an art and culture and a craft center for people in Kashmir. We did this in association with BRMA, who've also been associated in making the program for the Bihar Museum and other projects. So what we did in this case was to understand these three major questions. Whom are we building for? What are we building? And how are we building it? The three stakeholders, in this case being the local people, the craftsmen, and the tourists who are going to be visiting this place. Kashmir has always been a sensitive matter. With multiple stakeholders and with political intrusions for the last more than 30 years now, it's become a very volatile state. And what we understood staying there for about a month while we were doing our research was that the psyches have become schizophrenic. The context is not physical. The context is cultural, political, historical, economic, but it's definitely not physical. So what people carry collective memories in their mind and associations, and that is what we were looking at when we were wanting to design a project for this kind. The context given to us of these old factories, the idea was to celebrate Kashmir, to bring back what it used to be before all the insurgency started, to revitalize with basic skill sets, locals, career paths, tourism, and create a viability for the project. We also presented a financial viability. The three stakeholders, being the local community, creative community, and the cultural tourists, is what was the main objective of creating this project. We created a detailed program. There was no program given for a project of this kind. We all were supposed to interpret our own program. A very basic exhibition, art galleries, was given. But most of the program, 90% of it, we created ourselves, looking at what was required for a project of this kind. And we introduced certain very key factors like a parker, skateboard park, co-working spaces, things that would generate and that would become activators or simulators for the local economy in that region. We looked at a community platform which would go away from the political alliances or the historical alliances or the cultural alliances, but look at science as a neutral medium to restart with a newer generation on a neutral ground. To start with more sporting spaces where a lot of pent-up energy could come out, and it could come out into skateboard parks, and it could come to parker spaces, co-working spaces, or even looking at the craft production. We introduced a program called a black box theater, which would give a creative expression to a lot of theater artists there. There's a lot of street plays that happen in Srinagar. So giving a platform for something like that, and a tourist platform in terms of creating a new image for it. Understanding the silk experience, because there's still a silk factory that is functional out there. We wanted to create a tour of that space and weave the story of Kashmiri silk around it. We went into a macro and a micro level detailing of understanding each and every craft that exists in and around Kashmir, including all the connectivities or the flowchart diagrams that merge into each other, creating these crafts as a very symbiotic system. Even today, within that map of Kashmir at a macro level and a micro level program, we understood that each of these crafts are very interconnected from each other, just for the ecosystem that they create. We mapped the trees on site. We understood and simulated the water flow as per how it is. So we've developed our own codes and simulation to do all of these, and we have now used these in our practice on a regular basis to do these simulations. We identified with the conservation architect the buildings that could be restored, altered, something that could be rebuilt, and the buildings that could be demolished, which were the new buildings or the new additions that came in over the years. And a zoning idea or a concept, which was a merging of all of these things together and coming up with a third space for the community. We simulated people, as how Patrick showed today morning about the offices. We developed our own algorithms to simulate multiple scenarios. We used the tourist, we used the craftsmen, we used the local people, and we used the administration, and we mapped these scenarios on a regular day basis, on festival days, on biennale days. And coming up with these overlaps, we came up with the most probable paths that would be taken within this complex. And based on those paths, we were able to identify which building would be used for what function. So rather than just assigning a function to a building, these were a resultant of all the simulations that we created, and it was hours and hours of simulation to understand which is the most probable function allocation for each of the blocks within this complex. We would identify the three major plazas within this: the public plaza, the entrance plaza, community, and a sacred plaza. There exists a mosque which was built about 5 years ago out there, and that has become one of the cultural centers or the religious centers in that area. So rather than removing it from there, we wanted to rebuild it and revitalize that square, open it out without a boundary wall, so that that itself. So what we were looking at within these long buildings, these horizontal fingers that could enter and create permeable spaces. A design approach which was more urban and community oriented, landscape oriented, paving versus green, and a water network. We looked at water network, not just something that would take the rainwater from one place to another, but water that could be used for playing festivities, spaces for kids, like a labyrinthian system below ground that would be almost like tunnels that you move around in the dry areas, and also would help in flood mitigation, which is a very common thing in Srinagar. The architecture was designed keeping in mind, the interventions were designed keeping in mind all these factors, and the overall plan was generated, including a residential sector for the artists on the other side. The entrance plaza of the existing buildings. What we did do was change the roofs for each of this, and I'm going to come to that, the sections. We didn't get any drawings, so we developed our own drawings through our own drone shots that we took, our own footage, our own measurements of the site. In between, 370 happened, so we could not enter Kashmir, but we could do all of this virtually with the drone shots that we have to create very detailed drawings for that site. Art galleries, the community plaza with various functions, interconnection of spaces, the vertical versus landscape spaces, creation of a religious plaza, an open space that would lead to more interaction even during, so there is a lot of debate, political debates, cultural debates that happen during the namaz time. And we wanted to activate that into not just political debates, but into cultural events, Sufi events, and make it into a more positive environment for what happens, and make it more open in general. So, looking at that, the residential court, we didn't want to build any building out there, so we used the model of the houseboat, which was again introduced by the British. We used this as a model to say that why don't we reintroduce it, involve the artists to redesign their own homes using this model of a houseboat, which would be placed on site without any foundations. So ideologically, we were not wanting to build any foundation within this whole project. Whatever interventions we would do, those would be just placed like this. A system of new roof versus the old system. We developed these outdoor urban roofs, which were inverts of the existing trusses that are there, the existing wooden trusses. We just used that to integrate a new roof into that system. We also planned to take down the old roof sheeting, which was this metal sheeting, and weave it into these structures, these bridges that would connect horizontally. And this to us was an inspiration from the local arts or crafts of Kashmir itself, of this weaving, of putting this together using the old reused material.